Hello, this is Nero Must Die 1, and this is a random battle that I had with my friend at school. We were just messing around, and this is a team that I decided to set up. I decided to go out with my Archeops, Terror, because it, frankly, is the lead Pokemon at this point. And he sends out Torterra, I'm like, oh, he's gonna set up Stealth Rocks and all that jazz. It's gonna be really annoying. So I go for the U-turn, really, because I could have gone for Acrobatics, but really, I didn't know how much damage was gonna happen, and I expected him using Wood Hammer, so I just basically didn't want to take damage. So I just used U-turn and switch out to my Lila, which is a Rhea Necklace, and he uses Crunch, predicting my switch, I guess. Because he really doesn't like Rhea Necklace, and Leftovers really just helped out this walling situation here. He just keeps going on for attacks, and since I'm specially bulky, it does a lot, but frankly not enough. I go for a Psychic, thinking, oh, it doesn't have that many good special defense, let me just use Psychic. I'm like, oh, great, survived it, yay. I survived with 9 HP, I'm like, yes, thank you, Leftovers, but he gets the defense fall hack. Really does piss me off. I go for a recover, basically, because recover really helps out this battle, because I could just basically switch out, because I know he's probably going to use Crunch again, so I'm basically just going to switch out here and go to my Aggron here, because Crunch, fuck, still like 1 HP. My okay. Oh, he goes for a Wood Hammer. Oh, right. Wood Hammer, yay. Gets a critical hit. I'm like, what? Wood Hammer, critical hit. I survived it because of my bulky nature. I'm like, damn, this still did it a lot. I'm like, 252 in defense. I'm like, dang. He goes off to his Hydreigon. I don't want to, like, really do anything with this Aggron here because, frankly, can't really do anything else. Dead. So I go off into my Twin Blade here. My Twin Blade here is Jolly, and his Hydreigon uses Draco Meteor. I thought I was going to go first, but Draco Meteor missed, which really surprises me, because every time I see Draco Meteor, it hits, even for me, when I use it. So it really did surprise me that I missed, and I was actually lucky here, and I think if it did go down, really nothing probably would have beat his Hydreigon. So he goes out to Attaxus, I don't know why. He's probably thinking, oh, he can defeat it. I just use Dragon Claw. He's like, oh. Okay, so I'm predicting a sweep here because, really, Twin Blade has really high attack and can really do anything. So it goes up to his Black Core, which really surprised me. It's shiny. It's all blue and stuff. I go for a Dragon Dance here. I'm thinking, oh, okay, I can survive a hit, whatever he sends out, and then I can just basically just defeat the rest of his Pokemon because I'm going for a sweep here. And he uses Guillotine and it goes through. I don't know the stats on Guillotine, but Guillotine really is annoying and I don't know why he had it. He's just basically trolling me, as Joy says, so yeah. So I go out to Terror thinking, okay, it's time to use Acrobatics. I'm like, okay, gets a whole bunch of power down here. I use it and it frankly survives. I'm bulky, yet survives. Okay, sets up Sword Dance, because I don't know why he did that. I thought I was predicting Stone Edge, probably. But that's probably end. I just use Acrobatics to finish him off. Next Pokemon he probably sends out is Flygon, because Flygon really... He should have sent this Pokemon out first. I don't know why he said to it now, but I go for Stone Edge, thinking that it's part Flying, because I haven't versed that many Flygons, and not part ground, so I'm screwed. He goes for Supersonic. I don't know why he didn't go for any other move. Probably would have taken out this Terror, but he goes for Supersonic, which surprised me. So I just go for a U-turn, hoping that Supersonic won't really affect me. I'm like, oh, Supersonic's too weak to affect anything, so I'm like, U-turn. And I'm basically going to switch out to my Rhea Necklace, because I know it could probably take a Dragon Claw that this thing sends out. And his Flygon does have a Life Orb, which is the reason why it does so much damage to Rhea Necklace. And I know Rhea Necklace is going to go down, so he's basically staying so that none of my other Pokemon could really take damage. And he goes for a Hyper Beam, which frankly knocks out his Pokemon because of Life Orb. And really, Lila didn't get to do what it was supposed to do, but what can it do when Life Orb takes effect? So he goes to Salamence, and really, I went out to Terra because I know it had Earthquake, so I didn't want my other one to take an Earthquake because they are super effective to it. So I just go for a Stone Edge, and this really surprised me how I was able to take out Salamence with an Intimidate stat loss. I don't know how I was able to even take it out. I was really surprised there, and he's a permanent lead now because of that. So this is Nero Must Die 1, signing out.